All right. Welcome back, everybody. We are starting a new series here. One thing I really like to do on the stream is do complete series of games, games within a similar theme, games from the same franchise, in this case, games from Remedy that are kind of similar in many, many ways. So, let's get this started. Really, really excited about this series. I've been wanting to do this for a while now, and I just haven't had the chance. But definitely looking forward to it. I'm a huge horror fan, weird games fan, and Alan Wake, Quantum Break, and Control. That's about as odd and peculiar as you can get. But I actually did play Alan Wake way back in the day. Fun fact, this is actually the very first PC game I ever streamed. So this was 5 years ago that I last played this game. I don't remember all that much. I remember I'm a writer. I remember some stupid flashlight mechanics, but honestly, that's probably about it. So, it's not a true blind playthrough, but it's about as close as it can get. I've also never played Quantum Break, and then with Control, we did do a playthrough of when it came out. However, I didn't really explore it all, and I did not play the DLC, so all of that's going to be brand new to me as well. This is going to be a lot of fun. I remember very distinctly staying up really late one night playing this game on stream. One of my longest streams ever was Alan Wake, and whenever I streamed this, I was purely... The only reason why I even played this game was because it was at the time the very first game in my Steam playthrough, in my Steam playlist, and I wanted to see like how the computer worked and everything because I was excited about a new PC and everything. And then that evolved into like my very first stream being about 10 hours long playing this game. So I have fond memories, even though I don't remember specifics about the game. So I'm looking forward to it. Also, I had a garbage gaming PC at the time, so all my settings were at low. And, I was just saying, 5 years ago is whenever I first played it. It was my very first PC stream on Twitch. So I don't remember a damn thing. 5 years ago, I don't remember what I had for breakfast. But I think this series is going to be a lot of fun. It'll probably take us a couple of weeks, maybe 3 weeks or so, if that. I mean, I think that we can hammer home some long streams on the weekend. Just to let you guys know, I'll be streaming a little bit different this week. I'll be doing Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I'll be off Friday. We'll do a long stream on Saturday, and then I'll be off on Sunday. And then the following week, I'll be streaming Tuesday through Saturday. A little bit different than my usual Tuesday through Sunday schedule, but just some things have come up. And then also next week I want to watch the Super Bowl. So anyways, we're gonna get going. We're gonna play because we only got about 3 or 4 hours tonight, so let's have some fun in Alan Wake. And Rusty, thank you for the host. Rusty, more than anybody, has been begging me to play this game for a very, very long time, this series, so he will be very happy that we are finally getting into it. Now, for some reason, hang on, I gotta make this show up on my other computer. This is really weird, it was working a second ago. Okay, there we go. Also, you know what's really funny? So I found out this really peculiar issue with this game. So, like I've said, I hate motion blur in video games. Hate it, hate it, hate it, hate it. This game is very reliant on motion blur. So I turned off motion blur, and you know how, those of you who have played this game, how there's like this blur that's on the enemies until you shine the flashlight at them and then they explode, like that barrier goes off of it? That blur is tied into motion blur. And so if you turn off motion blur, you don't know when the enemy doesn't have their protective barrier. So we're having to unfortunately play with motion blur. It's what it is. I hate it, but whatever. It is what it is. We do have also the other episodes. The Signal and the Rider. We'll be playing that as well. I will be playing on normal. Actually, I don't even think... Yeah, because I was on my other PC. I can't even play on Nightmare. Because you have to beat the game on normal first. So, to answer your question from the other night, Rusty, we are playing on normal. I can't play Nightmare. And I'm not sure I really would want to, even if I did. So, here we go. Alan Wake.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
So this was basically me driving around in Mafia 3.
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone.
Episode 1, Nightmare.
Shot from the crash.
I will say this. Even though I've played the game, I am asking for no tips, hints, spoilers, all that good stuff. It is not new to me, but in the same light, it is new to me because it's been so long. So I am asking for no tips, hints, or spoilers. I don't care if I get all the collectibles or anything like that. I'm going to try to explore and have a good time with it, but in the same light... I do want you guys to behave. Rusty. No, I'm kidding. Alan Wake and its sequel, Alan Woke. We won't talk about the sequel to Alan Wake, the real sequel, because my God, it was terrible.
Hardly stand my feet.
Never play Alan Wake American Nightmare. It was really, really bad. I mean, there's a part of me that wants to for this series give it another shot, but I know I'm not going to enjoy it, so I probably shouldn't. Because I've already tried it, and it was bad. Funny enough, I'm not gonna pause all this time. I don't think I ever saw that opening cutscene because whenever I streamed this for the first time, I was just testing out my gaming PC, so I think I just skipped to the actual gameplay portion, and I don't think I ever saw that opening cutscene. Yeah, I'm gonna look all around and everything, but. I doubt there's anything back here, but oh my God, there's a lot of my books. I am a vain motherfucker. In my own dream, I have a ton of books.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there. I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked.
All right. Welcome to Night Springs.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Death number one.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Yeah, there's something waiting for me there. Hiking trail, Rain Cove Point Lighthouse. Missing. This random guy. See, that little fog thing? If you turn off motion blur, it doesn't actually exist. It's really weird.
You think you're God?
Yes.
Woo!
Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama.
Later, shit lord.
You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
I wonder. Hang on. If I scanned this on my phone, I don't have my phone on me, but do you guys think this would actually pull off something? There was a coffee thermos on the bridge, but since you got it once before, it isn't there now. Oh, so if you get something in the past, okay, that's cool. I wonder if that scans to something actual.
Joke. It would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You'll never.
He's talking shit about my writing abilities. Check my stats. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. Look, 3 manuscript pages found, 6 coffee thermoses, 1 radio show found. Wow, I really didn't find anything when I played this in the past. All right. I'm not surprised. Like, 5 years ago, I was not somebody that explored very much.
You missed your deadline.
Ooh, okay. Shift and then buttons. Okay, here we go. Woo! Ow! Apparently failed that. Yeah. Alright, come on. Bring it on. Woo! Woo! Successful dodges are sometimes highlighted with a cinematic moment. Okay.
Hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Moving on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Creation! Oh my god. No, it's... every game is easier to play with keyboard and mouse. Except Dark Souls. I would never play Dark Souls with keyboard and mouse. Oh god, get out of there! Oh no! Run, Alan! God, he runs like he's smoked like 15 packs. Go! You gotta go! Oh god, you shouldn't have smoked today. Okay, go, 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 go. I don't know who that is. Okay, Clay Stewart. I don't know who you are, though.
Oh, no. Stop. No. Damn it, die. No, no, no.
Yeah, I agree. I remember thinking of that Alan Wake felt like he had really bad emphysema. Oh, hey. That's weird. I don't want to die. Oh my god, what in the hell is going on here? That chair is rocking by itself. That's never a good sign. Let me out of here! Well, how in the hell do I get out of here? Ow! Oh god, I'm gonna die and I don't know how to. Oh, there we go.
Follow the light.
Okay, I can do that.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Ooh, light. Okay. Fill up my light bar.
Well done.
Oh yeah, that's pretty cool.
It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been, Do you understand?
No.
No.
See?
Follow my light. I entered your
well, thank you.
The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
My dreams are nothing like this. I gotta say, I dream of like
the hitchhiker has been taken over
really stupid shit. Like going to school naked.
Now, the darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Okay. Ooh, a flashlight.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
See, if you do that without motion blur, you don't see any of that.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him.
He just looks like a normal dude that gets hurt by your light.
He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Alright. Fire. Oh god. Oh god. But do you hear that breaking sound? Yes, you do. So you can actually play without motion blur.
I will give you back your dream.
But you don't get the visual indicator. Which is really weird.
A terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
All right, let's go to the lighthouse then. Boosting the light with that. Okay. Wait, where's that coming from? Uh-oh. Give me revolver ammo. I need batteries is what I need. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Oh, so you do actually have to aim. You don't get to just, like, free shoot wherever you want. Woo! Also, fun fact, when I first played this game, I didn't know that, like, I didn't pay attention to the tutorial, and I didn't know that you were actually supposed to, that you were supposed to use your light until literally, like, 3/4 of the way through the game. It is possible to win this game without using your flashlight, because I am the proof of it. I accidentally did it. But boy, was this game hard without your light. Whew. All right. Oh. Oh, there's something in there, I bet. Reload! Oh my god, dead co-carnage is coming after me. Okay, there we go. And his beanie. Dude, there's definitely something in there and I completely missed it. Oh well. Woo! Gotta go. Bye-bye.
I can keep this up
forever. Please don't. I think this may be our cue to run. Wait a minute. Okay, nope, you gotta run. I thought there might have been something in that van. This game's already 11 years old, that's crazy. Oh! I'm assuming this thing can catch up to, oh my god, it's like a tornado of destruction. Like all tornadoes are. Go! Sanctuary is right ahead. You can do it, Alan Wake. Now what do you think you're gonna do? The lighthouse is not safe.
He's here.
That was creepy.
Wake up.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Welcome to Bright Falls. The town where everyone knows your name. All right.
Let's act like we're on vacation.
Oh yeah, the lip syncing is absolutely terrible. You can't tell me what to do. You're not my mom.
I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten.
The hell you call me, boy? Is there anything up here? No. Nothing up there. All right, I'm posing for you. Take a picture of me, baby. Look at me. Yeah, and so the first time I played it, like I said, I had to play on really low settings. So this is pretty cool.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
Oh, skippity doodah, we get to go to Deerfest.
I'm Pat Maine, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Maine, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
I don't believe this guy. I think he's going to probably tell everybody that I'm here. And that's going to cause
nice.
A lot of problems.
Got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Hey, hey. Bye. He's not my friend.
Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah.
What's up with my name? There's actually some fancy lore behind my name, White Llama Poo Poo. So I was a big fan of Baloo the Bear back in the day, or no, Yogi Bear back in the day. And you know how Yogi is like, hey, Boo Boo. Well, I wanted to be White Llama Boo Boo because I'm a big fan of white llamas. And I really just, I have posters all over my wall of Boo Boo from the Yogi Bear show. And, but White Llama Boo Boo was unfortunately taken. So I thought, man, that's really crap or poo poo. No. So what it really is I made the name when I was just a viewer on Twitch and I did it as a, no, I'm kidding. I did it as like a joke kind of name so that whenever I subbed to some of my favorite streamers, they would read out White Llama Poo Poo. And so, like, it was like a positive troll kind of thing to make people laugh. And then whenever I decided to stream, I was like, do I make a new name? And I'm like, no, I think the same thing. I want a name that, you know, shows that, you know, I can make fun of myself as well as have a good time. And so there you go. That's the whole lore behind it. I don't particularly love llamas for any intrinsic reason. I'm not a big fan of feces, but together, it's pretty damn awesome.
Got it. Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great, great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay.
Ooh, I want to go to L. Jenkins Smoked Fish Company.
Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
She ain't having none of that shit. She didn't even change, oh my god, she doesn't change facial expressions one bit. WLPP is good for shorter too. Yeah. I don't know, I just kind of grew into it and where I really started liking the name.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Their relationship is so forced. It's really cringe.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
That's a little much.
Keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
I wasn't ready to leave. I needed to find
Look Carl at this float.
To get the key to the cabin.
68th annual Deer Fest. Oh my god.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
So you want to come to my hotel later? We could discuss my favorite stories.
I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
Yeah. What you reading there?
Are you on your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want.
Oh, she wants a piece of me.
Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
Welcome to Bright Falls. Oh my God, who are you?
I can really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
All right, I will oblige you.
You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think
it does
I won't
that.
Murder
Get
you
stuck.
In your sleep.
Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack.
Oh, I'll give it a whack.
Yes, that's my favorite tune. Coconut. Now that's what I'm talking about.
The lime in the coconut.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Lime in the coconut. Lime in the coconut. You put the lime in the coconut. Put the Hey, what's up, Rose? How you doing? It's good to see you. So, about you helping me out later. My wife is going to be at the doctor's office tomorrow. You want to come visit? The coconut. You put the lime in. What's her problem?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey. To get the key and get out as soon as
What?
Possible.
What's wrong with this lady?
Uber-eager fan is always dead.
Why do you have a lamp?
Told Rose last week that she should change the bulb. This is what happens when you get sloppy.
All right, I'm going in. Nothing bad can happen in a dark alleyway with lights going out. Everyone knows that.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Housekeeping?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I really don't.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife.
This lady's weird.
Thanks.
Who in the hell are you? Are you coming back from a funeral?
Place. Very inspiring.
She's a little weird. Does she say anything else?
I am so happy this could be arranged.
Me too. Weirdo.
You got lucky this time, young man.
I don't know what to think about that lady. Wait, can I go through the exit here?
Remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
All right, what about this?
I hadn't seen her leave. But the old lady was gone.
Okay, I'm gonna run now. I'm gonna get the hell out of here. Why in the hell where is she? Maybe she went into the room though. It's not necessarily ghosts.
Are you all right?
Can we turn the shit off now? You don't think you've ever seen that before? Good thing I'm very explorative. Let's see. Oh, there's my wife.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Bye, Rose. Wait, you know what? Come here. Give me a little kiss.
Alice was outside. I didn't want to keep her waiting.
I hope you enjoy your stay in Bright.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
She has no expression on her face whatsoever.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Oh. So wait, we're going to the wrong place?
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer. But that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years. Not since my last book.
Am I gonna get DMCA'd for Alan Wake? Of all the games to lose my channel over, Alan Wake. Diver's Isle.
It's gorgeous, Alan.
Wow, that does look really nice for an old game.
Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark.
Alright, so we're obviously gonna go up this mountain.
I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness.
Dude, this well creeps me out. I don't know why. Alright, honey, hang on for a bit. I'm gonna go hike up this mountain and see if I find anything. There's clearly a path here for some reason. God, I wish he could run a little bit faster. Yeah, so if this game's 11 years old, it was made in 09 or 2010. I mean, this does look really good for a 2010 game. Oh, there's my car right there. Why did we leave our car over here?
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg. Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
Why in the hell are we staying there then? Why are we staying in a place that has a dormant volcano underneath it? Alice, I think we may be in the wrong place. Can you call up the people that arranged this vacation for us? I think we might need to stay in like a brothel or something. Not a brothel. What do they call it? A commune or something? Yeah, we're not staying in a brothel, Alice, but let's not stay on top of a dormant volcano. All right, let's go. There's a lot of birds here. It's going to be like the start to Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds. Caw-caw! Oh my god. There is. It's shift, and I'm holding it down at the moment. And he does not run at this current moment. He's very picky on when he's going to run. All right, so we're here.
Dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on?
Oh, you need lights too?
Hello?
Not at all times you can't. What's here?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
It's like when it's story time, they don't let you. Alright, let's see if we can find the lights. Ooh, can we go in the basement? Because that's exactly where you should go in a horror game. Alright, I'm sure that the generator is like over here somewhere, but I'm just checking everything out.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
Why, though? What is this bot? It's the White Llama Poo Poo bot. Instead of naming my bot a different name. Yeah, so, fun fact, the reason why I do it that way is my bot, instead of having to purchase a subscription, I do it under my name so that my bot has access to my emotes without me having to spend any money. Life hack.
The generator had been connected to the power cable.
So for anybody that's a streamer out there, that's a really good way of saving yourself $5 a month. Thank you. All right.
I'll look around a bit.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that.
Oh, you horn dog. He just came here to get laid.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Yeah, so, like, my bots can actually, like, say, like, show my emotes and everything. So, it's just a lot better that way. All right, so I apparently was standing out here for, like, 7 hours. Like a weirdo.
Alice? Honey?
Why did she leave the door open? That's not smart.
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
The Deerfest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one.
Oh, I wish I could have gone to Deerfest.
We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBF FM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Well, hello.
Oh, it's Rose.
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it? He's my
favorite. Well, the word's out now. I'm in town. I guess it's fair because I didn't tell Rose not to tell anybody.
Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Main on KBF FM, and now some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
The water was black. I couldn't help but imagine all sorts of horrors lurking in the depths below.
Well, then, let's not go play in the black water. Alan listens to very strange music. Honey, where you at?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Okay. Oh, hey.
Guys, it's in the study. Go
No. You don't get to just...
Okay.
Oh, man. Are we really going to keep that radio on all night? That's going to really mess up the mood. Hey, I want you to be the surprise. Can you be the surprise? What if I looked out this mirror and saw, like, or this window and saw, like, a dark, shadowy figure walking out there? All right.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here.
Hey, energy.
Scenery would get you past.
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not...
Oh.
Alan?
Oh.
Just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Man, did I just shove her?
God damn it.
I knew she wouldn't follow me.
And I'm supposed to be the hero?
I needed some time alone to think things through.
I'm an asshole. I don't like Alan Wake anymore. He just shoved a lady. What a jerk. Well, apparently I don't care about her because I shoved her, so you're on your own, babe. Have a good one. It's been good knowing you.
I'm coming. It's all right. I'm coming.
See you later, shitlord. I'm Alan Wake, and I'm a terrible husband. All right, I'll go save her. For I am the man that shoves my wife and then... boldly runs into the house and saves her. Oh, shit. Oh, some things are coming back to me. Of a very bad boss battle that I remember hating involving birds. Oh, God. This is this game? Like, I remember enjoying this game, but this was something I didn't like, was there's a boss battle later in the game where it's a bunch of birds. And I, oh God, I remember. Oh, I gotta go through that again. All right.
Alice? Alice?
Where you at, Alice? Oh my God, did she just jump off the bridge? Or did she get pushed off the bridge?
Keep going, Alice.
Wake up. Alice?
horror genre. I don't remember it being particularly scary, though. More suspenseful and weird.
In the crashed car, felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice.
Like Silent Hill without the jump scares.
I'd have to find help on foot.
Let's see. What do we got here?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet.
Playboy!
It looked like a long
Every game should have there. Playboy magazines to collect. Even like Sesame Street teaches spelling. Surprise, Playboy collectible.
Damn.
Oh! Am I gonna get the insurance money for that, or are they gonna tell me no? Can I go down? I don't want to go down my car. I feel like I would fall down there and die. See, I can run sometimes, but this guy has like asthma or something because like a minute later, he'll not be able to breathe at all.
Hello? Hello? Is someone there?
A page.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh, wait. I forget. Is this something that like comes true? I think it might be. Oh, look. Whenever I did play this once, I happened to find three pages. The title page. Okay, let's look through these pages, I guess.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
I was awake. I was Alan Wake.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
So one thing that I actually don't like this mechanic, in that you can't get all the pages unless you play on nightmare mode, and you can't play on nightmare mode unless you already beat the game and have an active save file so that you can play on nightmare. I do believe that all of these pages should be available to you no matter what difficulty you're playing on. I especially since it has something to do with the story, I don't feel like elements of the story should be hidden just because you're not playing on the hardest difficulty. That goes back to like discussions we've had on accessibility in video games. Like imagine somebody that has genuine troubles playing a video game. Because of, and I'm not saying Remedy is a terrible company for doing this or anything like that, but what I am saying is this locks out people that may not have the reflexes or the time or the energy or the patience from getting all of, I think all the collectibles should be available no matter the difficulty, basically in every game. Personally, like it doesn't hurt my feelings at all if somebody's playing on easy and is able to get all these pages. So little gripe that I have, But I think now in modern day games, you're seeing less collectibles tied to difficulty. I agree, but some of these pages are really spoilery, specifically the ones locked behind the nightmare difficulty. Yeah, I get that, but I at least have an option for people to be able to... Or, if you really want people to play it twice, you know how you do that? Make it to where you can get these on any difficulty, but you have to play the game twice. And then everybody has to play it twice, but whether you play it twice on easy, twice on normal, once on normal, once on nightmare... I think that's your solution right there. I think accessibility in video games is very important. I will die on that hill. Like, that is... And it's something that, honestly, I did not always... Like, when Sekiro came out, people argued for, you know, accessibility modes. And at the time... I was like, no, I think that's the, you know, I used what everybody else says. Well, that's what the developer and the artist wanted. Let it be art. But I've come to realize that my, no. So here's what I'm saying. Little thing, right? So this game, some of these pages are tied behind difficulty. So, like, you have to, in order to get all of these collectible pages, you have to first beat the game on normal. That unlocks nightmare difficulty. And then you have to get these pages during nightmare difficulty. My feeling is that collectibles should not be ever tied to difficulty in games for accessibility reasons. Personal feeling there. I feel like certainly things like this, you know. Why tie it behind a difficulty? And it's just really odd. Doesn't make the game terrible, but in the same light, that's a decision that I don't agree with. Moving on.
Ooh. Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
And that's a stance that I've definitely changed on over the years. After listening to people, you know, I certainly think that you're not losing anything by having a game be more accessible to people, you know.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Like, what would I lose if Dark Souls had an easy mode? I would still play on Dark Souls normal mode, right? And I would enjoy the game. Other people would enjoy the game. We'd all enjoy the game. Like, you know. All right, let's go up this tree. By the way, I think there might have... I recall there being a thermos somewhere around here, and I think I already picked it up, possibly. In the previous playthrough.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident. Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
So I'm kind of realizing that I'm probably in a dream right now. Which is kind of funny, because I don't think I ever realized that in my first playthrough. Not getting to admire the Playboys unless on hard. I mean, something was hard, but not the game difficulty. Wait, what? Who the hell is this guy? Here's Johnny.
Figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe, like Nicholson in The Shining.
There you go. I made a good reference. Oh, you know Energizer sponsored this game. Freaking Energizer, Microsoft. Well, Microsoft publish the game, right?
During your recommend trying Nordic walking. It's the latest thing in
yes.
Test our
Great Fall Sheriff Station.
Ooh.
Hello?
Oh, that's not good. Wait, the power pole went down. We still have lights. Oh, we gotta go. We gotta go. We gotta go. Get out of there. Get out of there. I think we pro- Oh my god. Where am I going? Not that way. Apparently that was not where I was supposed to go.
During your recommend trying
Nordic
walking.
Yes.
The latest.
Right Fall Sheriff Station. How may I
test our blade?
Hello?
Roman let you
kill.
Come on, let me out of here. Okay, I don't know where I'm supposed to go. Oh, hey, found out where I'm supposed to go. I don't know why that's there.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Reload.
With a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared.
He's a fantastic shot for someone who's only been to a shooting range once. But then again, this, I believe, is a dream world, so I guess it makes sense. I mean, he is dreaming, right? Oh, hey, wait a minute. That thing says go this way. When all else fails, just kick the shit out of a generator. You'll be all right. Collectibles gated behind difficult levels would just turn me away from it rather than giving me replayability. Completely agree, Savorkin. Since I know I can't get them all in one go, I'd rather not hustle with it at all. I couldn't agree with you more. Very rare that I'll even replay games just in general. I mean, we're replaying this one, but it's been 5 years. Yeah, just I definitely am for more accessibility for people. I shouldn't have to be a god gamer to enjoy a game thoroughly, right? I mean, I am a god gamer.
The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
I mean, I am the Bashi. So does that make me a god gamer? I don't know. I leave that up to you guys to decide. Oh god. Now there are definitely games that I enjoy for the challenge. I mean Dark Souls specifically. Which by the way, we're going to play Dark Souls 1 again pretty soon. The remaster version, and then we're going to install a mod called Daughters of Ash that changes up, like it adds bosses. It changes up the landscape. Like, it changes a whole bunch of things. Yeah, pretty much all games I don't care about collectibles except for, like, Ghost of Tsushima and then the Playboys in Mafia. And even then, I stopped looking for all of them. Pick up manuscript. F5. Damn, I missed that many pages? How did I miss this many pages? I didn't go that far. Unless they don't go in order. Maybe they don't go in order. I haven't missed any. Okay, so they don't go in order. Okay.
Rose knew she had been gushing.
That would have been weird.
She didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his
Yeah, wife. Exactly. If she I want to play on easy and feel like a god, fine.
Not like Rose.
I missed one.
They were perfect for
Damn.
Each other. She'd have given anything to be
I don't really care. Like I'll look around and I will try to find stuff, but if I don't find everything, like it doesn't bother me. I'm cool. I just like exploring for the sake of exploring, not necessarily to get everything. All right, can I walk around this? Oh, it's the weird widow lady. Yeah, for sure. And Fallen Order, I played on normal. I think I would love playing it on a harder difficulty. But I think I could have had just as much fun playing it on easy, just because it's a good game. I mean, that's the mark of a good game, where no matter the difficulty level, you can still have a great time.
Inside my head, I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Yeah, I do that sometimes too, where I'll start on hard and then adjust accordingly. We did that with Ghost of Tsushima, actually. Oh, hey, I found a coffee thermos. Only 160 more to go. But yeah, I tried to play Ghost of Tsushima on the hardest level and failed miserably, so I just adjusted it. I'm assuming I'm going toward this town over here. Oh. I don't know where that's coming from. Ooh, manuscript page. Found another one. Barry's arrival.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon. But Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping. Messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
I feel like I'm doing pretty good with these manuscript pages, even though I'm not really trying for them. Alright, I'm not really sure where I gotta go. I'm assuming I gotta go this way, though. I just realized that I have a GPS on the upper left-hand corner. That might make things a little bit easier. That feeling when you miss one coffee, right? Like, you miss one collectible and you're like, ah, shit, gotta start the whole game over again. No, I'm good. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to this series. I think we're going to have a lot of fun. I've never played Quantum Break. Control, I went straight through without really doing any side stuff or the DLC. So, a lot of unique experiences. Plus, I'm going to be playing Control on PC for the first time at 60 FPS. So, that's cool. Because I feel like the one thing that held back Control was the frame rate on console. So, playing it on 60 FPS, I think I'm going to have a lot better of an experience. I don't have ray tracing yet. By the way, yes, I am looking at a new PC. Even though I have a 1080 Ti and a 7700K, I have already begun the search for a new PC. I would say within the next year, we are going to buy a new PC with a lot of the latest gadgets and gizmos, including ray tracing. Probably get like a 3090 and one of the better processors. May even do a two PC setup for streaming, which will really be nice. Yeah, 1080 Ti plays everything at Ultra for me so far. It'll play everything at Ultra. Streaming it is where I get a little bit of logjam on some games. My original playthrough of Fallen Order was on the hardest. Recently, you replayed it again with your partner. You started on normal and actually gradually worked your way up in difficulty level. All of it just as fun. Yeah, Fallen Order is one of those games that no matter the difficulty level, you're going to have fun. Now, I will say, like, it was pretty cool playing on normal and just feeling like a Jedi badass. So, like, I could see where even playing just on normal would be at just, you know, may possibly even more fun just because you get to be a Jedi badass. You stream on the same computer? Yeah, I do. I didn't buy two computers. Well, I did, but my last PC was Garbo. Reach the path above. How am I going to do that? That is a rhetorical question, by the way. And I've really had no problems streaming on the same computer yet either. But I can tell that it's going to start being a problem with upcoming games. Now, I am going to get a PS5, so a lot of that I'll be able to offload onto a PS5. So, all right, time to murder people. Woo! That guy came out of nowhere. I need to stop holding the flashlight once I, once I deactivate their shields. Because I'm just losing battery at that point. Look at that, we're playing Dead by Daylight all of a sudden. You know, that's a game I need to try out. I see all my friends playing Dead by Daylight. I have not played a single game of that. It looks kind of fun, honestly. I think I'd enjoy it. F5. Wake attacked by bird. I would need somebody to show me the ropes in Dead by Daylight, though. I feel like my learning curve would be far beyond everybody else's.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100.
Oh, that's a nice one, Point Zero. In the darkness. You could do everything on that.
And the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
See, the thing is, you'll be future-proof for a while. Whenever I get a new PC, it's with the idea of future. I've had this computer for about 3 years now, and 3 years later, I'm still doing just fine. My goal would be to last another 3 to 5 years. So, I mean, but yeah, with a 2080 Ti, you'll definitely make it for a good long while, especially with a two computer setup. Pick up shoddy. Ooh, I still like my pistole. I think I might be the only person that does not like shotguns in general in video games. I hate it because it's not accurate from long. Obviously, shotguns are not accurate from long distances. And I kind of hate that because I like sniping people from long distance. I got a bad feeling about this. Am I just making a bridge here? Yeah. There is a thermos over there. Hang on. Hold up. Not in an FPS, yeah. And not in a third-person shooter, either. They're good whenever people are, like, up close with you, but... Alright, I'm assuming now I have a bridge with which to cross this. Very odd that they have a ladder leading up to the top of logs. Should try Apex Legends shotgun snipe in that game. What? I got a few friends that play Apex. I need to get into an FPS at some point, like a multiplayer FPS, like COD or something like that. I enjoy them. I'm just so bad at them, and I feel like I never can learn strategies to make me feel adequate, you know, and I always, every time I play it, I'm like, yeah, I'm terrible at this, and then I quit playing it forever, even though I really enjoy it. Like, full disclosure, I really like FPS multiplayer games. Titanfall 2? I might have to look into it. I've tried, like, I love Battle Royale games, but I'm terrible at them, you know? I don't know the strategies that everybody seemingly does, you know? And so then I just get frustrated after getting, like, picked off by a 13-year-old, and I just move on with my life. What's up in here?
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably...
I have EA access. Still up and around. I bought it. I also bought the PlayStation streaming thing.
The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like... The forest is quietly breathing.
PS Now or something?
As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild.
You're a pervert.
But here I am, and don't keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to? Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find him.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
This is a really quiet game at times.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah,
I hope the audio mixing in the future games in this playthrough are a little bit better. That's another complaint I have is the audio mixing in this is not very good. People are insane at FPS games. You're shocked from the fact... Oh, yeah, like... Now, granted, you play hundreds of hours of a game. You're probably going to be pretty good at it, whereas I have, like... a dozen hours, if that, in a game. PS Now was a bit laggy, even with good internet. I didn't have a problem with it, but then again, the game selection, most of the games that were, like, featured on there are already owned. So, I don't know how beneficial that is for me. But I still have it, oddly enough. What did I just pick up? Wake attacked by Bert? No, I must have just picked up this one. Oh, yeah, that's unread. Okay, Wake finds pages.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery.
I tried it on the PC app that they have.
Save Alice.
Maybe it's improved. Maybe it's better now than it used to be. Because, I mean, I tried this literally like a month ago. Like, it was recently.
The gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming in the darkness.
Ooh. Thermos.
The best gourds in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no curves. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Do these guys actually say anything of note, or is it just really weird rambling? You tried it when it came to your country years ago. Yeah, I would presume it's got to be better now, because I really didn't have problems with it at all. That's not good. Woo! These guys throw axes at you. Ow! Let me roam around in the woods without throwing axes at my face. Oh, that's a page. I just sold it to you. I mean, why not try it for a month, see if it's any better for you?
I stepped into the gas station.
Look at me. I'm an influencer now.
The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Maybe you're going a little bit crazy. Oh! Oh, I stepped into that one, Cotton. I definitely feel like I missed something over there, but okay. It does feel like the pages, for the most part, are not like stupid hidden. Like they're kind of in the pathway that you're trying to go in. All right, we healed up. Like, you gotta search a little bit, but it doesn't ever feel like you're way going out of the way. Okay, I wonder what these arrows, like, are they trying to tell you where to go, or are they telling you where collectibles are? That would be another good thing to note. Does this game have sequels? Not a full sequel. This game has American Nightmare, which I didn't enjoy the first time I played it. Oh, they're telling me where hidden caches are. Okay. I'm going to give... you know what? Screw it. I've made the decision. We're adding American Nightmare to this series playthrough. I really did not enjoy American Nightmare whenever I played it. But it's been 5 years. So maybe my tastes have changed. I don't know. I'm willing to give things another shot. I'm probably not going to like it the second time. But it's not a true sequel. There's rumors of another sequel coming. Especially with one of the Alan Wake DLCs. I've heard that one of the DLCs is very much true to Alan Wake. Again, I haven't played the DLCs yet, so I don't know. Yeah, AWE. But we'll see. I think that's another good reason to play this game, is to see how it ties in. All right, let's pick up this page right quick. Dude, I am knocking this shit out of the park with these pages.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help, but I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
I'm only missing one page out of the ones I can find, since we can't play Nightmare. Wait, I already had a shotgun.
Science. It bestows.
Is this the Twilight Zone?
To advance it, to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode. Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen,
this reminds me of Control.
I am Dr. Barclay Colvin.
With the little TV things. Moorcock. I'm such a pervert. I'm sorry.
Interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment.
And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
And then he shoots and kills himself.
What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing...
Oh, is this like Final Destination? He cheated his death, so he's about to die?
Colvin? Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality! Poor, poor doctor.
He killed himself. Ta-da!
The crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. Night springs.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Alrighty then. Is that a collectible? I think it is. TV shows found 1 of 14, yeah. We found 2 of 11 radio shows. I know I didn't check out the TV show. See, like 5 years ago, whenever I first started streaming, I tried to hurry up and finish games real fast. Now I'm very much more of an explorationist. I'm just looking all around, making sure I don't forget a page. I think I may have missed one, but... Oh... Wait, is it just a regular dude? Oh yeah, that may have been. Ow! Ow! Heal. Oh, he can like move really fast. That's not good. Time for you to die, son. Oh, this is like a boss battle. Oh, look at that.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
All right. Guessing I do something with this. All right, before we go in there, let's have a look around our premises here. We might find something useful. Maybe like some guns or something. What if we get an Uzi in this game? I would imagine Uzis are not weapons of choice. That would be cool. Go restock on bullets. Did I have a restock bullet? I have a lot of bullets. For some reason, I don't remember ever like being dead on bullets in this game. I don't see any bullet restock. Did I play Red Dead 2? Yeah. All of that's on my... That whole playthrough is, I believe... Yeah, it's on my YouTube. As well as... as well as all of Red Dead 1. But yeah, we streamed that. Had a great time with it. I do want to play it again, though. I very much enjoyed it, and that's another one I played on console that I would love to play in 60 FPS. All right. Well, we found a thermos. So that's cool. I feel like nothing is ever, like, in these grass, like, these weeds off to the side. I don't think I have yet to find anything over there. Oh, look, it's Deer Fest.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls.
I didn't try the online. Alice. Can I get in here somehow? I guess I need to go off to the side over here. Hopefully the game's not too quiet for y'all. If I turn it up anymore, the loud moments are going to be way too loud.
At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
The game is like really quiet until the loud moments, which is really weird. Oh my god, I think I found all the pages for this chapter, y'all. Take a look at that. I found all the pages to this chapter except for the nightmare ones. I have a sense of accomplishment on that. I feel pretty good about that.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
You know, it's really weird. The FFZ compressor, if I activated it, it makes things louder for me, but in a good way, where the highs are lower, but the lows are higher. If that makes sense. Well, that makes sense because that's exactly what a compressor does. But anyways, yeah, that's a pro tip for everybody, by the way. Get Frankerface Z if you're watching this on computer, and they have an audio compressor built into FFZ, and you can hear your streamers better. Like highs are high or highs are lower, lows are higher. It makes things sound really good. I use a compressor myself. But even with that, theirs makes it even better. Wait a minute. Do I want to go this way or do I want to go that? I feel like they want me to go there, so I'm going to go this way. I see something blinking over here. Nope, I think I need to go to the gas station. Also, if you're a streamer, Frankerface Z is just really good in general. But even as a viewer, like, you can get really good experiences with it.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
So I need to get inside the gas station narratively, right? But I did see some kind of blinking object down this way that I want to check out. Oh, that's a thermos. All right, well, I don't really care about the thermoses, but I'll get it. Ah! Ah! Well, you're not supposed to kill me. Oh my god, I have to start all the way back here. All right, I'm sure that we'll go over there to get the... Wait a minute, I would have gotten that thermos already though, right? Like, I don't have to go back. I've already picked it up, right?
Gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Because now that I know a thermos is over there, I keep the thermos. Okay, yeah, I didn't see it glowing over there. Wait a minute, what's down this way? Well, I didn't see it glowing whenever I looked down that way. Anything down here? I do wish you could sprint, like, nonstop. Alright, I don't think anything is down this way. Ow. Yeah, it doesn't look like anything's actually down this way. I think we just wasted our time. And I don't see any flashy things that way either. Oops. This rider must never, like, do any kind of cardio. Because I feel like I could run faster than this guy. I think there's a mod. No, I looked for mods. I did look for mods for that. Because I was going to mod it out. Yeah, believe me, I was going to mod it out. Oh, by the way, y'all, going ahead and announcing before this series even goes all that far. The next big series we're going to be working on is a blind playthrough of the Far Cry series. And now, I have made that decision.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
And yes, one day I will definitely go back to Final Fantasy.
All right.
Ooh.
I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this.
Yeah, I'm going to play them all. TV, talking now, crazy. Let me pause to say this. Far Cry 2, I am going to mod out Ebola. I know about Ebola, even though I've never played the game. I am modding that shit out. I am not dealing with the Ebola from Far Cry 2. No way how. And I've also done some graphics mods on 1 and 2 already. And there's some gameplay improvement that I did for 1 that doesn't make the game easier, but makes it a lot more user-friendly, essentially.
Was I losing my mind?
But other than that, we're going to be playing vanilla for the series. No, you ruin it. No. I am not playing with the Ebola. There's no way. That would make me just quit the game. The 68th annual malaria, whatever. Ebola, malaria, same thing. What's up, Corgi? 68th annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition... pie contests and surprise competitions, live music. These posters are collectibles. Ah, cool. For the children, Bucktooth, Charlie, and Montgomery, the Mystics, amazing Phantasmagoria evenings. I need to play Phantasmagoria. Don't miss the legendary Deerfest parade. I'm sure it's fantastic. Is it bad that I knew just looking at that box before I read wiper that those were windshield wiper boxes? Just because that's what I do every day is deal with parts. That's literally my job, is a parts guy and a shop. And like I looked at those boxes and I was just like, oh yeah, parts. Windshield wipers. Here we go.
Brightfall Sheriff Station.
It is a very useful skill. Hello.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please,
oh.
I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Wouldn't you want to take me to the hospital first? There is no cabin in the woods. There never was. Dun dun dun. They call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room. All right, we beat the game, everybody. Good game. Just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper. Good game, everybody. Go to sleep. Everything is all. That was fun. I forgot that this game was in chapters. I close my eyes. Then I.
Previously on Alan Wake, I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
Yeah, just wait until we play Quantum Break Energy. There's literal segments where it's like 20-minute TV shows that we're just going to sit here and watch. That's going to be fun. I've never actually seen them, but I'm looking forward to it.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
I guess I need to give Twin Peaks a look-see at some point. Oh, so this, I got a nice house. They're longer? Oh boy. Yeah, we're gonna be playing the hell out of that game. Alan Wake, What I Can't Forget, an Alex Casey thriller. Ooh, I got a manuscript page.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake. Thinking in metaphors again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me. This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now. My wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
He's kind of a shitty author. I wouldn't read his books. That is a cool painting. I like that.
The continuing freezing rain and heavy snowfall have necessitated a winter storm warning in the entire tri-state area. People are advised to stay indoors, as many roadways are already closed, and city officials are not expecting snow crews to keep up with the weather. We're now on the third day of the blizzard, and the weather is not expected to clear up anytime soon.
I could see why people would miss this radio. In my mind, my wife told me to go to the kitchen and grab some coffee, so I'm like, I'm going to go anywhere but the kitchen to grab some coffee. Like, I try to do exactly what the game tells me not to do. Ooh, pills. Dude, I got a really nice house. People use radios in modern time, or the game takes place in the 50s. I used to use a radio growing up. I used to not be able to sleep without a radio. Now, the only sound I want is my box fan. And it doesn't matter how cold it is outside.
But these shots are turning out great.
I will always have a box fan.
Need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
Okay, I know that guy's supposed to be Alan Wake. He looks nothing like Alan Wake. Damn, I hate it when doors are locked in my own house. Wait, is that an eyeball on the window over there? That's odd. Can I go outside? No. Also, this guy looks oddly like the guy from Heavy Rain. Jason? Jason! I was wondering why this guy looked so familiar, but he looks just like the guy from Heavy Rain. All right, here we go.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
All right, go to Alice. All right. Hey, baby, you ready for some sexy time?
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
Oh, she performed a miracle last night, giggity.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called.
I still want to know if doing a scan with your phone of that thing will actually pull up anything. Because we've seen it several times. Check the fuse box. All right. Oh, that's a fuse box?
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
Hey, okay? How you doing?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I'm just shining the flashlight right in her eyes.
It's stupid, but it's just... Especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
Thank you. You put the lime in the coconut.
How do you feel, Mr. Wake? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take
it easy. Leo Galante. He sounds just like him.
Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me.
Oh my God! It's the guy from the Geico. Is it Geico? The Geico commercial where he's like holding the dollar on a fishing pole, and he's like, "Ha ha ha! So close, so close."
Doc Nelson was the image of a small town.
Y'all know that commercial?
Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head. I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that, coming from an old...
Hang on. We're going to see if I can find it. I want to show that I know what I'm talking about. Let me see. YouTube. Let's see. Is it Geico? Geico fishing dollar commercial. Okay. Can we show this on stream? I think we can. I think we'll be fine. All right. If anything, like, why would they DMCA me for showing a commercial that would sell their shit? Okay. All right, here we go. No thanks. Okay. All right, let me rewind this. Go like that. Oh, man. Hang on. I'm trying to make it work. Properties. Okay. And then put that over game capture, maybe? Yeah, there we go. All right. This is what I'm talking about. Just so nobody thinks I'm crazy.
Hello, beautiful.
Oh, it's State Farm? Okay.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Hi, Anthony. How much did my discount double check save me?
About $150.
Done.
I don't have State Farm, but insurance, find me money.
Got you a dollar.
That's him.
Oh, you almost had it.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you with unexpected savings. That's getting to a better state.
Anyways, State Farm, if you're watching this stream right now, and I know you are, you don't need just Aaron Rodgers as your spokesperson. Come talk to White Llama Poo Poo. I just sold State Farm insurance on stream. No streamer's ever done that, I promise you. Step aside, Ninja. You've never done that. Ha! Freaking top streamers don't sell State Farm insurance. I will. All right.
Women like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
So that guy looks just like the guy from the commercial, and he's got a fishing pole. That's fantastic. Oh my God, y'all remember, some of you are probably too young to remember these kind of PCs and these little asshole printers.
Just go down the corridor.
Check how many manuscripts I've found. Okay. I have found 12 of 106. In this episode, I've found the first two already. Yeah, I've already found the first two. These two. Yeah, these two. Sheriff. Wait, I don't want to be here if the sheriff is here. See, I like these scenes. Oh, it's the weird lady. I like these scenes better than I do the actual gameplay of the main game. Have you seen this man disappeared on June 20th, 07, identifying features knack for winning contests? Joe Biden? Missing Richard Baugh, Bruce Damski, Jacob Miller. On a camping trip, overdue, haven't been in contact. If you have seen them or know their whereabouts, please call 555-9932. Thank you. These are definitely all the developers of the game.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
I'm not talking to Sarah
Mr.
yet.
Wake?
Wait, where'd the crazy lady go?
You in her office down the corridor?
Where'd the psycho lady go?
That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric.
She used to be
the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that.
Weirdo.
Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
I don't want my cell phone. I want to go visit all these. Found me a manuscript page. Alice sees
Alice
a shadow.
Through the viewfinder, lining up the shot. Cauldron Lake was breathtaking. Something caught her eye. A figure standing in the shadows behind the cabin, like a thin woman in a black dress. She lowered the camera and looked again. No one there. Just a collection of bushes that looked vaguely human-shaped. She shook her head and laughed.
Found a coffee thermos.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas.
Yeah, she did.
Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the parade float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsals today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stuckey. Jane's out.
All right. Yeah, I really like these scenes.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
More than the actual gameplay. To me, the gameplay isn't very strong.
I needed help to find her. I wasn't ready to leave.
But the story is very strong. Ooh, what was I supposed to read? Oh, I already read that.
Your phone, Mr. Wake?
Yeah, let me search your office first. This is totally normal, searching a police office for all their shit. Alright, there we go.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stuckey's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up.
Yeah, don't tell the police that you were fighting with your
Excuse
ex who
me.
Is mi- or your wife who's now missing. Not the smartest.
Hello?
Alice, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Oh, shit.
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're going to meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
I need some fresh air. Can I go out? In the back, maybe?
Of course, Mr. Wake. I understand. You can get there through the cells. Deputy Graham can show you the way. Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
Oh, it's the fishing guy.
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
I thought he quit drinking for good.
Mister. Hey, can you...
Thank you, man. Thank you. Hey, you're all right.
I like this
you're
guy.
You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell you different. You know, I shouldn't even be in here. The cops, they got it all wrong. See... Sure, I beat him up, but I wasn't drunk. I mean, I wasn't drunk at the time. I only got drunk afterward. Okay, listen, you gotta listen carefully now.
All right.
Here's the kicker. That was... cousin Danny. No, sir. It only looked like
him. Oh.
You wanna know who it really was? I'll tell you who it really was. It was a goddamn space alien!
What?
I know it sounds like something a drunk would say, but believe me, I wasn't drunk then.
I believe you, dude. I 100% believe you. I don't know why. Hang on. These cops should let you go. Let me tell them.
You can get to the back lot through that door.
Time to raid Area 51. Hey, lady. I think that guy in there, Walter or whatever, I think he's innocent. He punched a space alien in the face.
Lot is through that door and down the corridor.
I couldn't go anywhere yet. I had to play along with the caller. Alice's life was at stake.
Hey. Walter might be. He might be. Ooh. There you go. Found me another page.
In spite of its human mask, to describe the dark presence as intelligent would have implied human qualities on something decidedly inhuman. Nonetheless, it found the one spot in the diner that was dark enough. Some light spilled into the corridor, ravaging it. But it took the pain. Horrible as it was, the writer would soon fix that. He would be coming to the one place where it still had power. The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Ooh, here we go.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. Broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street.
Hey, Decaf.
Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating.
At one point I was. I haven't played it in probably a year and a half, though.
The big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
You called out a bigot on Facebook today, and they reported your post for cyberbullying. Go figure. It's freaking snowflakes. All right.
The caller had told me to find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car.
Reserved for town employees. I'm really enjoying it, especially now that I'm more, like, I played this 5 years ago, but I rushed through it, and I'm definitely more, inquisitive. I'm looking all over, everywhere for things. Where am I supposed to, how am I supposed to get through this fence? Yeah, we're gonna do all the DLC. All the extra chapters of all these games. We're doing everything. Oh my god, I can't figure out how to get through this damn fence. There is a page over there, I see that. Yeah, we're gonna play American Nightmare. I made that decision. I played that in the past and I remember hating it, but We're gonna try it. I'm gonna do it all. F5. Let's see. Wake at Lover's Peak.
The kidnapper fired his gun one last time, and the shadow vanished into the darkness it had come from. See? Nothing to it, Wake. The thought of Alice in his hands was revolting. We stood on the wooden platform of Lover's Peak, the waterfall in the mountain behind us, the lights of the radio mast blinking red in the heights above. I fought with the urge to take a swing. Force myself to speak. Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife? Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
So somebody kidnapped my wife.
Barry? Ow, thank God. Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. I've been
a week?
I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Al, what the hell is going?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
What do you mean I've been here a week? There's no way that I've been here a week. Oh, he's sleeping. See, a guilty person would not be sleeping right there.
Shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible.
A week after the car crash? Really?
I'll save her.
And I've only been playing for 2 hours, and a week has gone by? Who's this douchebag? On their recent and regrettable little
outing. They are not accountable. Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches.
Ugh.
The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to
you douchebag.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Punch him. Yeah!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
Was he almost accidentally going to get hit by a car during the cutscene?
I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Oh, Rose is here.
Barry, you found him.
Hi, Rose.
Hey, Rose.
Wow, I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later.
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. Takes a Swing at Everybody.
I'd come here to rent a cabin where I could wait till midnight.
She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you.
The skeleton of a Colombian mammoth. This specimen, estimated to be 14,000 years old, was recovered from the La Brea tar pits in 1981. It was donated to the Elderwood National Park in 98 when the Colombian mammoth became Washington State fossil. Named Bucktooth Charlie, it has since become the park's official mascot. You think this game's going to get remastered because it's not on PlayStation? If Alan Wake 2, if they do an Alan Wake 2, I would not be surprised if they did a remake. If they don't, then probably not. All right. All right, I'm not going to go over there. Not yet. Oh, man. I thought there'd be something over there. Excited for Resident Evil 8? I need to play Resident Evil 1 through 7.
Seriously, Al. What you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared?
But yeah, it looks good.
When's the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
No. Look, Barry, I'm missing a week, and someone's got Alice,
and everything's just... Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that?
Ooh, health cap. Oh, man, I was so used to Mafia, I thought that they were going to give me a health pack. Oh, my God. Is that Rusty? Rusty, is that you? I did play 7, yeah.
Easy there, boy.
Not any of the DLC, though.
Hey, Rusty, right? You're on Cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap.
You can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing is... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
All right, I'm gonna read this. Cougar, Puma. Reddit. Boom. Wait, is this the same kind of bear that was in people's offices and all over Mafia 2? I think it might be. I had a dog just like this at one point in my life. We called it Frisbee.
I think this is the form you want.
Ah, fair point, Energy. Fair point.
Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
0 out of 10 game for not being able to pet the dog.
If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that.
All right.
Look, Al, you're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him.
Yep.
You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with two long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on. I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
All right, let's go. I was kind of hoping they would let me explore the outside over there.
We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her.
This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Who's he?
I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay, okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo!
He's got the Rona.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be Deliverance all over again.
That's another movie I've never seen is Deliverance. I've heard a lot about it. I'm not really sure that that's the kind of movie I would really enjoy, though.
This is so not worth a 15% commission.
I'm just, like, looking around for anything. What do we got? Batteries? Thermos? There's gotta be something around here. Okay, so we can go back here. or over on this side. See, they want me to go that way. So I'm going to go this way. Okay, no, I'm not. I still vaguely remember a chapter where you had to fight off a bunch of birds. And I remember absolutely hating that exact chapter. But I don't remember if that... I'm assuming it's this game, because we've already seen birds. But there is definitely... How many chapters are there? I think like 5. Ooh, hot tub. But, again, you gotta remember, I went 3/4 of this game without realizing the flashlight killed things. So, I think that may have made the bird part a lot harder.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
I love that he's talking to me while I'm, like, way away from the house. Shrek point. Ooh, wait, I saw something. I saw something interactable, and I don't know what it is. Yeah, am I going crazy? Oh, there we go. Oh, there's the manuscript page. Okay. I was like, I knew I saw something.
Barry had never gotten along with Alice, but he knew Alan loved her with an almost frightening intensity. And now something had happened to Alice. And here was Al armed with a gun and saying things people got put in padded cells for. It was as if his friend had experienced a massive psychotic episode and was now totally disconnected from reality. It scared the shit out of Barry.
I think we're doing pretty good. Wait, I can drive that? Oh.
Wasn't a long walk to the visitor center, and it wouldn't be any use to me in the forest.
I think we're doing pretty good on these manuscripts. We got all the ones in chapter 1. And I think we've gotten all the ones in chapter 2 so far. So you don't want to rush. You just want to, like, look around and see if you see anything. The good thing about this game is they do at least make the collectibles glowing so that you can see them from a distance. I really appreciate when games do that. Instead of just randomly plopping it in the weeds somewhere. Being like, have fun, find it. Ooh.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage.
Oh, man, you're amazing.
Really, just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Oh, tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
Yes, exactly, Bat. But I'm going to check out the parade, of course. And I'll be one of the pie contest judges, too.
Well, does anybody know, was this game released in chapters, or was it all released all at once?
It's my kind of exercise.
Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a largemouth
all at once
early this morning.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that competitive anymore. Now I just like to take my time and enjoy the peace of it.
Oh, I don't have any of my weapons except my revolver, no.
You know?
Well, considering your track record, the participants are probably pretty happy you feel that way.
Well, Pat, that's kind of you to say.
I do like that the people you meet in this game, they all tend to call the radio station. It's kind of funny.
Oh,
Okay, so I'm thinking they want me to go that way. Ooh! What the hell was that? Okay, there's got to be something down here because it looks like the main path is over there. This game's getting a little spooky now. An avalanche? Really? Well, obviously, we're going to check out this house. Elderwood Nature Trail, the Moonshine Cave, and Lover's Peak. Who needs Lover's Peak when you've got an RV like that? I think one day, like, whenever I retire, I'm going to, like, get an RV and just go around the country. Oh, really? Found a TV.
Crime and punishment. The cancer and cure of civilization. But some crimes are impossible to punish. Especially in Night Springs. Tonight's episode.
To killing that guy, huh? Why?
Had it coming?
Yeah, but why would you do that? I mean, you're a nice guy. Normal. Took a kid to a soccer game. So how come at the game, you pick a guy and, quoting from the arresting officer's report here, assault the victim's head area repeatedly with the weapon of choice being a pair of bare fists? Wow, that sentence really flows, huh? Maybe you're not the literary type. Okay, so you mess him up. But why? Was that guy? We couldn't ID him. Why would a guy like you do him like that?
I didn't like his face.
Well, you must have hated it, because you really went to town there. I mean, there's no way to tell what he looked like. No ID on him either.
That must be difficult.
But then we ran the fingerprints. Got a match. Your prints. Identical.
Huh. How about that?
Your son said you were wearing a white shirt when you took him to the game. The white shirt is on the dead guy.
Identical twins.
It's plenty red now.
Yo, Jay Reed, what's up, buddy? How you doing?
Do you really think that's in any way relevant to me? I had plenty of time to talk to my boy before the cops arrived, you know? He won't stop screaming, am I right? You think he's ever gonna be okay? I left my mark. Believe me.
You bastard.
What? You gonna shoot me? What's the point? You got me.
I don't understand any of this.
And you never will. Don't worry. Maybe you'll see me again, Agent. Maybe in the mirror.
Hmm. Alrighty then. What's up, Jay Reed? How you doing? Guys, definitely go check out my boy, Jay Reed. Another really good caster, good friend of mine. Huge, huge donger. Definitely check that out. Why is there blood here? That's really odd. Donger huge as the day is long. Damn right. Alright, I think we found everything over here. Onward and upward. Let's go. Loved it. Great series. A lot of people dogged on 3. I enjoyed 3 a lot, and then the rest of the series was just phenomenal. Definitely recommend playing it. Especially now that the remake is out of 1. Do not feed wildlife. $100 penalty. I mean, is there really somebody just out here enforcing that? I still haven't played Yakuza yet. That's definitely on my to-do list. Let's see. Rose and Rusty. Look at that. Okay, Rusty's about to get him some. Here we go. Here we go. Rose and Rusty.
Rose knew that Rusty was in love with her, and she liked him too. She liked him a lot. He taught her to dance, and life had certainly taught her the value of a man who was gentle. He treated her well, made her smile, made her feel good. But Rusty wasn't the prince of her dreams, and that tended to underline the unbearable truth. She was no closer to that Hollywood magic than he was.
Yeah, I think I'm kind of waiting for... There's a few of them that aren't on Steam yet that are coming. And as soon as all of those from the Yakuza series, I think that'll be another series I do in the future. Ooh, more manuscripts. Man, I am not... Rusty dying. Rip, Rusty rages regularly. There we go.
The air in the visitor center was heavy with an awful
smell. I'm doing good with these pages.
Some rotten drowned thing had crawled up from its grave. Rusty kept coughing blood. My eyes were drawn to the twisted shape of his broken leg. The attack had been vicious. Max whined in his cage. Rusty's eyes were wild with fear and terror. He gasped. Mr. Wake, it happened just the way it was on that page.
So what I'm writing is, like, coming true. I think this is all, you know what? This couldn't be a dream. So this is real life. The last, much of that last chapter was not real. Dude, I have no idea what's real and what's not at this point. We gotta search all these houses. Hope you can fend for yourself for a little bit. I'm gonna search these houses. Rusty, hang on. I'm gonna search all these houses first. Alright, Rusty attacked by the dark presence.
The visitor center was sturdy, but the impact turned the front of the building into splinters. Rusty was thrown across the lobby like a rag doll and hit the far wall hard. It didn't hurt until he tried to move and saw his leg bend the wrong way.
Oh, he got Alex Smith
stabbing him on the inside. Rusty howled in pain and fear, suddenly afraid to die alone.
Dude. Oh my god, there's so many pages in this. I thought we were going to finish this chapter today, but I've got about an hour and a half left to tonight's stream. We might be cutting it close. Again, guys, I will be streaming Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday for sure. I'm going to try to get on. Let me go ahead and go through this spiel. I'm going to try to get on Friday, but I got to get my car washed and I have to go to bed early on Friday. We're going to be starting late and probably ending around midnight, so probably about 4 or 5 hours. And then Saturday we'll do our normal 10 to 12 hour shift. What's after this? We should get into something together. We definitely do need to figure something out. Let's talk soon, Reed. I'm going to be going through the Far Cry series after this series. We're doing Alan Wake, Quantum Break, Control, which is all Remedy games plus the DLCs. Far Cry is going to be my next series because I've never played those games. But yeah, I'm always down. We should figure something out and co-op some shit. Oh yeah? Think a first playthrough of those, I'd probably rather do single player, but Project Zomboid. I'll have to look into that. That sounds interesting. I'm down, dude. Definitely always down to work with other people and have a good time. Dude, I don't think he's doing so good. I feel like, dude, I feel like I'm missing something. But I don't know where I really could be missing anything. Rusty, hang on, buddy. I gotta search for things, Rusty. Chill. Yeah. Hit me up anytime, dude. Like, I'm always down. That's one thing I really want to do more of this year is, like, co-op stuff with other streamers. Because I feel like that's something I really haven't done really at all in the 5 years I've been streaming.
Mr. Wake?
Oh, hell.
It happened. Just the way it was.
Yeah, generally weekends are going to be where I'm available.
True. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must... The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back. Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
Wait, he found a page? Well, I need that page. Give me the page. Where's the page? Oh my god, can I shoot the dog? I'm kidding. I definitely do not have the page. Nope. No unread pages. I do have a key, however. Do you have a switch? I do have a switch. Zool bought me a switch. And I have barely played it, but I need to get the lights on. Oh my god, how do I get the lights on? Oh, I have a GPS system in the upper left. Okay, here we go.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on.
Hello. I saw the manuscript page down there. Zool's your sugar daddy too. You're sitting in his chair. Maybe the Mario game coming out in mid. Oh yeah, I didn't know there was a Mario game coming out, but definitely interested. Absolutely. F5. Wake reaches a safe haven of
at
light.
At the last instant, I changed direction and threw myself down. The axe splintered the trunk of a tree.
I love Mario.
Bright light. My lungs burned. I was too exhausted to move. I tensed as I waited for the killing blow, but it never came. I raised my head. Nothing moved in the darkness beyond. For the moment, bathed in the cold light.
I really need to play Mario Maker 2 some more, too. Those were always fun streams, and I feel like I did, like, two Mario Maker streams, and then I just stopped. After that, Riders Republic, which is like Steep 2. Then after that, It Takes Two, which is a mandatory two-player game. I'm in. Absolutely. Hit me up anytime. We'll do it. I will be your tag team partner, Jay Reed.
That was too late.
Ooh, that's
someone
not good.
Destroyed the circuit breaker.
That is
there
not
was
good
no
at
way
all.
To get the lights back on.
Rusty, no!
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness.
Oh, I'm in. I'm all in. Let's do it. I'm so in that I don't even know what It Takes Two is, but I want to play it with you. Because It Takes Two. You can't play It Takes Two with just one person. I'm in. All right, return to Rusty.
Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole.
Ooh! Can I get out this way? No. Yeah, I'll definitely look it up after the cast. Don't feed the animals. It Takes Two is the new game by the dude who made No Way Out. Oh, okay. I'm in. I still have to play No Way Out. I haven't done that one yet either. Because I don't have friends. Oh my god, Rusty, I have to kill you. Well, if it's me or you, I'm sorry, but you're gonna die, Rusty. All right, we're booked, Reed. We're booked. You might have to remind me. look, I want to do any kind of co-op stuff. I'm terrible remembering things. But if you just hit me, yeah, just hit me up. I'm in. Woo! Oh, and by the way, everybody, I don't remember if I've mentioned it on stream. So March, starting the first week of March, so our company gave us a free extra week of paid time off since we worked through COVID. And so I took vacation the first week of March. We're going to be doing another week of streaming where it'll be probably 12-hour days every day. Also, we're going to be doing the same thing the last week of May. We're also going to be doing the same thing in September. That'll pretty much be the vacations. But I'm doing it all this stream. You do got to use the shotgun. Well, I don't have a shotgun. They erased the shotgun. Yeah, I want to stream a ton this year. I saw I only streamed 420 hours last year, which is pretty cool, 420. But I want to at least quadruple that this year because I didn't really stream that much in 2020. All right. Definitely feel like I'm missing something, but I don't think I am. Zul, we were talking about how you're both of our sugar daddies.
I saw from the window. I saw something.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy.
Jay Reed and I are going to be doing some co-op cast coming up, Zul.
Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
So it's like you're our pimp, and we're just your little horse. God, what? Where am I going? This way? All right. Ooh, found me another page. See, here's the key to finding the pages. If the GPS tells you to go one way, you go the opposite way, and then you find the pages.
In that last instant of consciousness, Rusty thought about Rose. He was older than she was. Rose was barely out of her teens, but she made him feel young. And forget what a train wreck his long-dead marriage had been. He still wore the ring. He'd been waiting for her to tell him to take it off. Now she never would.
Aw. Rusty, you almost got married, dude. What am I supposed to do with these cans? Am I supposed to shoot them? Are these collectibles? You can tell me that. Oh, those aren't collectibles? Well, then why am I interested in them? Let's see. Oh, actually, I was supposed to go that way. I thought there was a whole nother path that I could have gone on. All right. So sometimes the pages are right where they're supposed to be. They're stacked in a pyramid of five. Are you supposed to shoot them? Or do you gather them? You shoot them. Okay. Now, we're not trying to get all the collectibles. We're just trying to get all the collectibles that I can find. And then at the end of the game, we'll be like, hey, look at all these collectibles I found. That's pretty cool. And then we're going to move on.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
Moonshine Cave. Screw Lover's Peak. I'm going into Moonshine Cave. Let me through. Why am I going in this cave? I love that I was supposed to go to Moonshine Peak and Lover's Cave, and I'm just like, nah, I'm gonna go to Moonshine Cave. You can't tell me what to do. You're not my mom. Ooh, shoddy gun. Ooh, lithium batteries. Moonshine Cave. This cave was the site of frequent and lucrative bootlegger activity throughout the Prohibition. It was mostly used for temporary storage of alcohol smuggled from Canada, but at times alcohol was also distilled on the premises. Neat. I mean, like, if I had a choice to go into a cave called Moonshine Cave or go to I don't get lovers, so... Moonshine. I drink instead. Zool is the closest thing to a lover I have. Found a porta potty and a hat. Whoop! Okay. I thought maybe the hat would be a collectible. It's not. Is the porta potty a collectible? It is not. All right, let's go to Lover's Peak. Yeah, that's how No Way Out was as well. Which I do need to still play. Okay, so they tell me to go that way. I'm gonna go this way. You know there's gotta be something over here. Somewhere. Wait, where's the... Shouldn't there be something over here? I mean, I went out of the way to find something, and I'm not finding anything. Oh, there it is. I knew something would be down here.
Nobody in Bright Falls seemed to know where Al was, but Rose, the waitress at the diner, had seen him. From what Barry could tell, Al pretty much fell off the face of the earth when he left the diner. Rose was just the kind of fan that Al hated, but she really tried to help. She was smart, too. Knew a lot about what was going on in the town. Knew a lot about Al. Even knew who Barry was. Barry liked her. That was no big surprise. When it came to women, Barry and Al rarely saw eye to eye.
There's still a lot of pages to be found, and I probably have missed some. I mean, I've tried my best to find all of them that I could, but this is definitely a more expansive chapter than the first one. Okay, there's got to be something at this pickup truck, surely. Nope. Oh, I think we're gonna have some enemies coming up. All right, no pages over here. Let's go. They want me to go this way. I'm gonna go this way. Wait, I think I've already been this way. I think I'm just going backwards at this point. Maybe not? Question mark? Ow! Woo! Yo! Dalton! Dalton, thank you for that raid. Really do appreciate that, Dalton. And welcome to the stream. Welcome to the White Llama Show, everybody. We're happy to have you. Dalton, how are you doing? Welcome to the show. Let me give you a shout-out over here. Really do appreciate you bestowing your community upon me. Last playing, I have never seen that game in my life. I hope you had a great stream. Welcome to everybody from Dalton's stream. Those of you that don't know me, I'm a variety caster. I stream 5 to 6 days a week. And right now we're going through some Remedy games such as Alan Wake, Quantum Break, and Control. So we're going to have a good time with that. But we're happy to have each and every one of you for this. How goes Alan Wake? You really enjoyed this but never finished it? So far, I'm really, really liking it. That's like an actual raid horn. We need a shelter that we can hide in. Yeah, I found that sound effect on the Streamlabs Pro, which I, for some reason, signed up to. I think it's a big ripoff. but I found it, so now I'm subbed to it for a year. So, Duke! Thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Welcome to the Petting Zoo. Good to have you. Midweek streams generally a little bit slower or a little bit shorter. And then weekend streams, we do 10 to 12 hour streams every day. So anyways, welcome everybody. We are more than happy to have you here in the Petting Zoo. Let us continue. Where I just got destroyed by a dude. Okay, so apparently there's like big old brutes that I totally dodged and he still hit me. Oh my god. Jeez. Yeah, I'm super early. Chapter 2. We might want to take out the ads first. That'll work. So, save the shotgun for the big guys. How about that? By the way, I really wish you could, like, melee these guys, too. The great old one, felled by lightning in 1937, this exceptionally tall Rocky Mountain Douglas fir was over 200 years old. According to local legends, it stretched beyond the stars. After it fell, it was measured to be 66 meters tall, nearly a record length. So yeah, definitely gonna save shotgun for big guys. Seemed to put him down pretty quickly. And I'm going to go ahead and run. There might be. I don't have fond memories of Nightmare, obviously, but I do remember the combat at least being better. Oh my god. Stop it. Oh my god. Okay, this section got a lot harder than any other time in the entire game. Although I should have seen the light and... Oh, no, you have to start this. Okay. So I would have died had I tried to start this light. Jeez, that was tough. Oh, there's a hammer, bro. Somewhere in these woods. Ooh, can I get that? I'm not trying to get all of these, but... Oh, there's a thermos down there, too. Okay, we'll have to remember that. I'm pretty confident I can't jump down that way, so... All right, what do we got? Wake sees the torch
I
symbol.
I turned the corner, afraid of what the flashlight's beam might reveal. Suddenly, a
roughly... roughly, I believe so, yeah.
Behind it, hidden by a rock, sat a battered metal trunk. It was here for a reason. Packed with supplies, batteries, flares, ammo. Things you need to make it through the darkness of the night. Something left...
Hang on. Dalton, I want to make sure I'm following you before I just completely forget to do so. Okay, so. I am. Okay. Behind by someone. I'm really bad about that. Oh, it's your Roadhouse. Okay, I didn't know your new name. Okay, so Roadhouse. What's up, buddy? It's good to see you. I didn't know you had changed names. Bear alert. Woo, we got a big boy. We got a big boy. Okay, so they take two shots with the shotty, probably three shots with the handgun. If I had to guess. All right, Energy, take it easy, buddy. Take it easy, man. I will see you around. I feel like there's got to be something back here, right? There is not. Believe it or not, there is nothing back here. Happy I got the poo-poo back in my name so the shirt's still relevant. It is. It is. I have a much better shirt now, I feel, but you have the vintage poo-poo shirt. I think the vintage poo-poo shirt is still on the store, though. I'm pretty sure. I'd have to check. I haven't looked at my, like, shirt store in, like, ages. Because let's be honest, nobody's really buying streamer merch these days. I still do. Like, all my friends I support and I get their streaming gear. But, I don't know. It's been a long time since I've seen people buy streamer attire. I'm sure it happens in bigger communities. Am I going backwards again? Yo, I think I'm going backwards again. Yeah, I have a bunch of streamer friends shirts. Some of them they gave to me for free. And then some of them I bought. I think I am going backwards. Yep. Well, like, you know what confuses me is, like, I try to go where the game doesn't want me to go to see if I can find, like, hidden pages or thermoses or anything. Like here would have been a prime example of a place that could have had a page, but it doesn't. Through tree. Okay. People are dicks about it too, like Zul. Dude, Zul's the worst, isn't he? Okay, this has to be the right way. I know it's not the right way, but this is where we haven't been. Motor vehicles prohibited, no littering. Dogs must be leashed at all times. Oh, there's a page there. Oh, you can definitely go this way. Oh, wait. I might not want to go this way just yet because I might not be able to get up. Let's check out this little area right over here first. You told some dude on stream earlier today that you wanted to strangle him through the camera. Strangle Zool or strangle a random viewer? The tree this ring was cut from started... I am not reading this. Needless to say, things happen based on the tree rings. Oh, not you. Okay, that's good. I tell Zool I want to strangle him all the time. It's usually sexual, though. Oh, backseat gaming. Ugh. Yeah. You know what gets me? It is... And I know people don't mean anything by it, but when people go... Oh, he's at this part. And it's like, okay, that's not where, that's not technically a spoiler. Now you just made it obvious that something crazy is about to happen. And now it's ruined for me. I don't get that sense, you know, that just wait for this part coming. I hate when people do that, dude. I hate when people do that. Nightingale's arrival.
Agent Nightingale didn't want to be in Bright Falls. These little communities revolted. And he didn't like the trees or the coffee. He now knew that impossible horrors lurked behind the storefronts and smiles. He desperately wanted to turn the car around and just drive until he passed out or ran out of road and booze.
But exactly.
He had a rider to catch.
And where I won't usually be an asshole to somebody unless it's obvious they're purposely trying to troll. Like, it irritates the shit out of me inside. Yeah, Rusty, you're way better at doing it. Because I mean, I'll be the first to say you used to be terrible about that shit, but you're way better about it now. Like miles better than like years ago. You used to annoy the shit out, and I'm just, you know, we're good friends and everything, but now years later, I can tell you used to annoy the shit out of me with that stuff. But you're way better about it now, like, miles better. Like, I feel like I can say that years later, because it's like, okay, but we're cool, you know, like, we're good, you know. Like, I mean it with love. I mean it with nothing but love. Because you have improved. And that makes you a fantastic human being. Did I just get hurt by the closing door? I glitched out the game. Bam! I got Alan Wake. I did it. So up to this point, I had not glitched the game. I definitely glitched the game just now. Boom. The streak continues. Ooh. Oh, that's a glitch. If a slowly closing door knocks me to the other side of the pedestal and hurts me as though it's fall damage, that's a glitch. It's a small one, but it still is a glitch. Ooh.
Come on, we gotta get moving. More of them coming.
Who is this fine fellow?
That flashlight's kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
Yeah, but flashlights last forever. Flares are, like, small. Like, you don't get a ton of flares.
You can see them too?
Ooh, middle mouse button to use a flare. That's interesting.
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
What? I lost my gun?
Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, wait. You better keep up. Me and this guy are going into Lover's Peak together. Maybe we're going to have a menage a trois with Alice. Ah! I feel like I'm going to have to go off the venture path to find pages here. You wanted to go to Lover's Peak with me, sir? Okay, let's go. I don't know if that was a moment that you wanted to use a flare, but... Good job, random guy.
Lover's Peak, right up these stairs, Wake. Use the flares from the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
But I want to see if something's over here. Dude, nothing over here, huh?
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back talk. Hold him off, damn it.
Alright, we gotta use the flare. Yep. You shall not pass. Uh-oh. You shall not pass.
I almost got it. Okay, it's open. Move it or lose it.
I'm moving it. What have I been up to? Work and streaming. That's pretty much my whole life at this point. But really having a good time. Come on. Come on, random stranger guy. Let's go into the light. Why is this guy so mad at me?
Better get ready. They'll be on us soon.
Think of all the sex that has happened up here on Lover's Peak. Oop, found a thermos. Have not found many of those.
This is it, Wake. Last stand. There's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Ow. You shall not pass. Oh, save me. Save me, Obi-Wan. Uber nerds, Gandalf is a fire wizard and the gray is for the ashes. I love Lord of the Rings. I need to do a Lord of the Rings movie marathon soon. Maybe we'll do that in Discord sometime. I'm just gonna unload all my flares here. Because I don't think there's any point in saving them at this point. Because once we get to chapter 3, my inventory erases. So there's really no point in holding on to them. The lore runs deep as the mines of Moria. The mines! Ooh! Big boy. Ooh! There's a guy here. Multiple guys. You are a terrible shot. You're like a stormtrooper. See? Nothing to it. That's all I needed.
Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her all.
I mean, I understood him falling, but... Come on. Let's go get him, Alan.
You're gonna give me the manuscript or you'll be sorry.
Ooh, wait a minute. No, wait a minute.
I swear I'll kill you if you hurt Alice.
I see yellows.
Come back here.
He had Alice, and he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
I see these yellows, so I know that there's something somewhere around here. Oh, maybe over here. Hang on. Oh. Wait, this isn't the cave. No, this is a different cave. Look at that. Found me a different cave. Nice. All right, make it through the woods. I got this. We might be able to finish this chapter tonight. I got about 45 minutes left that we can stream tonight, so maybe. I feel like we're pretty close to the end. Well, actually, we may not. Let's see. Alice's Fear of the Dark.
On more than one occasion, Alice had tried to explain to me how it felt to be afraid of the dark. To her, darkness wasn't simply the absence of light, but something more tangible than that. It was something you could touch and feel. Worse than that, it was something with a mind of its own, something malicious and malign. For her, things changed when they were wrapped in darkness. They turned into something else, something foreign, and nothing was safe or innocent anymore. I'd never really understood what she meant.
Until now. For anybody that missed that. Ooh, I would never walk across that. I'd be like, my wife is not worth it. I am turning around and doing something else with my life. Mind you, I've never been married, and that's probably a reason why. I am not willing to sacrifice my life for Alice. I will find someone else to woo that will not expect me to die just so that they can live. Is that selfish? Absolutely. But I'll be selfish while still living. On my yacht. Not dead. Nothing over here. Ooh, we're getting close to the old radio tower. Okay, I think I'm going the wrong way. How do I get through here? Oh. No, that's not how you get through there. Dude, it's so easy to get lost in these woods. Oh my god, what is this? Dead by Daylight? Ow! Damn it!
Rusty had warned me about these traps. It hurt like hell. I was stuck.
Watch out for the trap. Dude, there could be traps all over these woods, too. There's a trap. Wait, are these shinies supposed to tell me I'm supposed to deactivate them, or... Ow! Damn it! Well, at least they shine. Even though it clearly didn't help me very much, because I still... Damn it! God! Oh, I can tell I'm gonna hate this section. By the way, I think the hitbox on these things are kind of brutal. Wait, I could go that way. But I definitely feel like there's probably some stuff over here that I want. Ooh, Paige.
Sarah didn't care about the legal threats Wake's agent had made. She let Wake go without argument, because there was something about him she couldn't quite put her finger on. Something that reminded her of her father.
She didn't His think big penis. Wait, what?
Then she thought about the way he waded into Hartman. That hair trigger rage flaring up without warning.
Oh, hey. Why is... Alan Wake is so smart, and yet he doesn't think of just getting one of those beer can hats and putting road flares in the holder, right? And also, hey, Dr. Boo, why am I not able to shoot that? There we go. It was easier once I aimed my flashlight. Wait, is that really a... No, 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 no. I don't want to quit. I don't want to quit. Statistics. Let's see. Cardboard standees found. I found one, and I read it. Why isn't that counting as one that I found? That's not fair. I did knock over a can pyramid. Why didn't that count? Maybe that one doesn't count as far as the ones you're supposed to find. Collectibles aren't Playboys, I know, right? Woo! Oh, it's DLC, oh. Ow. Yeah, let's get out of here. Let's go this way, maybe. See, they want me to go this way. I feel like I saw something over this way, though. Maybe not. Ow! Alright, let's head where we're supposed to then. No more of this off the beaten track. It doesn't work. Uh-oh. I hear footsteps. Where are they coming from? Oh, there you go. I'm out of ammo. That's not good. That's not good at all.
The night had been one desperate situation after another. I was exhausted, and my body felt as though it had been chewed up and spat out. The flashlight was heavy in my hand, and each pull of the trigger sent a painful shock up my arm. But I was finally out of the woods, and things were looking up. That's when I heard the chainsaw.
Chainsaw? I don't even have gun. Oh, I have shotgun. I don't have much shotgun. See, I didn't know that was there. I have two shotgun shells, and apparently some maniac with a chainsaw is about to show up. Oh, hey, here we go. All right, I have ammo now. We're doing okay.
I had heard the plane fall. It made no sense.
What plane?
It was clear that it had just fallen here. It was very old and obviously hadn't flown in decades. Looking at it sent a shiver down my spine.
I don't remember a plane at all. Ooh. All right, let's go this way. Wait, there might be something inside this plane somewhere. Maybe if I take off the black sludge, maybe I can fly this thing. What is this, Lost? Yeah, really. Okay, it says go this way. Let's go this way. Maybe we can fly off this rock. Wait, I gotta go up? Okay. What? So maybe I go like that, and then... Oh, look at that. Found it. That wasn't a great cache. All right, let's go towards the light. When all else fails, head towards the light. But first, let's go this way because there's probably something over here. feel like that's where I want. No, no, no. There's definitely some stuff over that way. Actually, I think that's the way I'm supposed to go. Oh, this is where, that's where I was. This is where I'm supposed to go. Okay. Yeah, I'm not fighting any of y'all. You're out of your damn mind. Oh, I guess I probably am gonna have to fight them, huh? All right. I think they should put a GPS in bottom left or right. I think that they should have the option of where you want to put it. Some games do that. And I love when they give you that option. Okay, I think we're okay. We got a checkpoint here. Like, I personally don't really mind it where it's at, but I do forget to check it every now and then. Ooh. Gotta be more than one, right? Why do they put them out here if there's no, like, collectibles out here? Hunting rifle ammo. Ooh, I have a hunting rifle now? Hell yeah. That'll certainly help. I'm just looking around to see if I saw any shinies. Alright, I gotta get across there, so it looks like I gotta go down and around, maybe. Again, we will be live tomorrow around 6 o'clock. I will try to start earlier if at all possible. Sometimes I can start around 5:30. It just really depends on traffic and when I get home. And how hungry I am, because I didn't eat dinner before stream. I'll be eating after. Sometimes I feel like I have to eat something or I'm going to pass out. So we'll see how that goes. But at the very least, we'll start by 6 tomorrow. And we're going to do the same Thursday. Friday, I want to stream. But we're going to be starting a little bit later. Wait, I don't have to fight these guys. Yeah, there was like no reason to fight them. Okay, what's up here? Now suddenly Alan Wake has turned into a platformer. Woo! Oh. Oh, now you know that there's some kind of puzzle mechanic. Oh, there probably was some kind of... No, it doesn't look like there was a page up there or anything. I wonder what clearing that sludge does. Because it doesn't seem to give you anything. Maybe that's a collectible too. Out here. Ooh, manuscript page. Grab that manuscript page. Deputies at the login site
was a mess. The modular office had been pushed off the cliff. Deputy Thornton climbed up from the wreckage, excited, breathing hard from the exertion. Nobody there. It's weird. Don't you think that's weird?
Bored, Mulligan let out a mighty snort. Hell, it's always weird, Thornton. Just a question of sorting out what kind of weird it is this time around.
You know, we might actually... We may finish this chapter tonight. I'm not sure how long we have left. But that would be a really good closing time, is if we could finish that chapter tonight. Kick that. Oh, there's a page over there.
When Barry saw the darkness attack the visitor center, it made him a believer. The men Al said he'd shot, they hadn't been just locals on crank. Somehow the world had changed, like the channel had been switched without warning. You think you're watching a sitcom, and you're really watching a horror show. When the birds started attacking the cabin, Barry wasn't surprised, just terrified.
Like, I get why you want to clear that sludge, because you wouldn't be able to get through otherwise. Some of the sludge is just random places. Like on that airplane. Alice, I'm coming for you, baby. Okay, I feel like that was there just to scare you. Ooh, what does that say? The darkness wears her face. Beware of widowmakers. What? More ammo. Yo, that hunting rifle is really, really good. Anything in here? No. You can climb those boxes in the shed, can I? Oh, hey, look, there's a manuscript right there. I feel like I wasn't supposed to be able to reach through there.
I felt the dark presence turning its gaze toward me. Then the moonlight was blotted out by dark shadows that raced violently across the ground, moving too swiftly. Darkness gathered between the trees and melted again to reveal the Taken. No natural path had brought them here.
Yeah, I just reached through the whole damn cabin there. I mean, to be fair, there are empty holes. Yeah, it looks. Yeah, you definitely can, and that's how you get the page. But I don't. Where we're going, we don't need no stinking boxes. Oh, there's definitely something over here. I feel pretty strong. There's gotta be something over this way, huh? Really? Dude, I feel like I search every nook and cranny. And, like, the ones that are, like, super duper obvious that they should reward you for, like, searching, there's nothing there. Oh, these are big boys? I'm out of batteries. That's not good. I think we can survive on flares, though, so I think we'll be all right. Also, you can flash them with the minimal flashlight, too. It just takes a little bit longer. So you never actually run out of power. Also, we just found more batteries. Found a hiking trail. Thank you. Oh, chainsaw boy. All right, I bet you this guy's difficult. Kill random ads with handgun. Flare it up. Yo, I'm getting pretty good at the combat in this game. The big boys, you use the heavy artillery. The random ads, you use the handgun. Use flares on the big boys so that they don't charge at you. We should do a no hit run of Alan Wake. No, I'm not gonna do that. I probably could do it. The hardest ones would be the axe throwers, I think. Like, even the brutes, that wouldn't be so hard. It would be the random axe, like, coming from behind you. That would get me every time. Alright, let's go. Hey, the game... Current games have better combat, but it's not bad combat either. For sure. Ooh, I got cell phone reception. Oh, we're gonna have to do the bird boss battle.
Stay hidden.
Oh.
Be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on.
One problem, I only have one thing of flashlights. Oh, there has to be something in this tent, right?
I was out of the woods.
Nope. Oh, give me more batteries? This game is really good about giving you batteries at the right time. I will say that. Like, when games are way too stingy, it can be not fun.
I'd have to get the car from the locked garage. It would get me back to Barry faster.
Ooh, do I get
and
to drive?
Were a welcome bonus.
All right, they're definitely not going to let me drive. It's going to be like some kind of cutscene, I'm sure. All right, I guess we're going to the men's bathroom. You know what I haven't seen in a while is a TV. And I don't think there's going to be a TV in the men's bathroom, so. I got garage keys. Oh, hey, there's a TV.
A story is not a machine that does what you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own.
It's like I knew.
Shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
You know how they could have made this really scary? If while you were watching... I should be a horror designer, because what I would have done is while you're watching the TV, they know the character's looking at the TV. I would have had somebody like run across this little open doorway over to the right there. Like, or just like a slow walk. I think that would have been really cool. See, like, that's not scary. I was low-key almost expecting that. But, like, if they had somebody just slowly walk across that would have been creepy as hell. I love when horror movies do that. Like, instead of, like, jump scares, they have something subtly happening in the background that nobody expected. Wait a minute. Where are the toilets in the girls' bathroom? That's a little odd. There are no toilets in the girls' bathroom. That's sexist. What do? Shit on the floor? That's disgusting.
The FBI agent's command froze me in place. I considered surrender. It was all falling apart anyway. I could give in, let someone else deal with it. But it felt all wrong. Call it instinct, his posture, the way he held the gun. He
was. I don't think that's true.
Shots ringing in my ears, I leaped for the hole in the fence and stumbled into the darkness beyond.
Oh my god, look at this. Chapter 1, I got all the pages. Chapter 2. Of course, we're missing the one on nightmare mode because we don't have nightmare. Oh my god, there's only one page left. Am I gonna, like, low-key get all of the manuscripts without even, like, looking things up? Because I feel like that's pretty impressive. There's no way. I'm gonna miss something, obviously, but... I looked through all here. I'm pretty sure that there's not, like, anything in between these RVs. Yeah, I looked through all this whenever I came up here. I mean, I don't care if I get all the manuscripts, but I've done remarkably well at getting them. Oh my god, are they gonna actually let me drive? Oh shit. Don't you know that I've learned Mafia driving now and I'm really good at it? Y'all, I'm actually just looking for pages at this point. Because it would be totally like this game to just randomly put a page on the side of the road somewhere. And that'll be the one page I miss. I'm literally searching for manuscripts while driving this big-ass truck. There is hunting ammo over here. Hang on. Also, okay, so now I super think that there's gonna be. There's gonna be some kind of note at one of these areas. So I need to be on the lookout. Those cans were smoking meth. Did I invest in GME GameStop? No. I knew it was a fad that would just go away. And then I'd lose my money on it. Because it's gonna crash. I mean, it is. It just is. Let's see. Dude, I think there may be a page back there. There is a thermos over here. Woo! Oh, shit. That's not good. That's not good at all. I think I found the page. I think I randomly found the damn page. Oh! That's hilarious. I don't have a truck anymore, but I have
there
the page.
There was no misunderstanding. Cauldron Lake was where Alice and I had stayed, but there was no cabin and no island. I was missing a week. What had happened to me? What had happened to Alice? I had to get her back. I couldn't face life without her.
Am I able to, like, use other trucks, or am I just, like, absolutely screwed at this point? I guess I could purposely die at this point and get my truck back. So I guess dying wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Oh, you can use other cars. I did not know that. Let me just kill these people. Or get enough distance between them so I can run to another car. How did I start that car up so quickly? I did not hotwire that car that fast. Also, I'm so used to the car mechanics of Mafia that I'm just struggling with this one. The hedge fund that was short selling the GameStop stock required a $2.5 billion bailout today. Oh my god. All right, Barry, where you at? I already got all the pages, so I don't care about pages anymore for this chapter. I don't think there's anything else that I need to do. Uh-oh. How do I get to Barry? Oh, God. Maybe I go around? All right, I need this car. I'm gonna have to requisition this car. Oh, I can't requisition the car. All right, I'm gonna go get my other car. Because I run like I have emphysema. Oh, I thought that was another page. I was like, did I find an extra page? Oh, come on. Go! Can you imagine if I just walked all the way up this hill? That would be miserable. Uh-oh. Y'all, I don't think I'm gonna be able to drive up here. All right. Oh yes, I tend to remember this. Flare gun, though. Was probably the best weapon I that might against help. The dark things I was facing. Damn. Yeah.
kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake! You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
Not done?
Nope.
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. If not, well, get me.
Yes, yes, I get you.
Oh, shoot. I thought the birds were about to attack me. Do they not attack? Oh, okay, near this house. See, I do vaguely remember this boss battle here. And I remember hating it. So let's see if I end up hating it again.
Over the phone.
Although the flare gun would be really awesome against birds, I would think. Yeah, I hate this just as much as before. Where you at, birds? Jeez. Jeez. I need more batteries is what I need. Such a dumb. Oh, man, man, man. Yeah, I'm going to pass on doing the Reddit trends. Because I'll pick one and end up losing on it.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Oh, I think we just beat chapter 2, by the way.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I think that's a trap. I heard her voice.
Have a great day.
Yeah.
Hope you come back soon. Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Well, dang, Sansa's all of a sudden not feeling too good. All right, so we finished chapter 2. We will be picking up tomorrow with chapter 3. Again, we are doing a playthrough of Alan Wake, Alan Wake's American Nightmare, Quantum Break, and Control. Never played Quantum Break. I've played the other two, but it's been a while. And topic of Control, I've never done the DLC, so all of that's new. Definitely looking forward to it, for sure. I don't know if I need to. Yeah, I guess we can quit right now. Yeah. So we'll start with chapter 3, and have a great time with it. This was definitely a fun experience. I think I'm enjoying it more than I did the first time, where I just kind of rushed through the game. Definitely exploration is vital to really having a great time with the game. So anyways, I'm going to host somebody up. I hope you all have a good night. I'll be back by 6 o'clock tomorrow. Hopefully a little bit earlier than that. That's Central Time. And we're going to have a lot of fun. So thanks, y'all, for coming by. All the support. I really do appreciate it, as always. And I hope y'all have a good one. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.